So angry recently bought a PC.
Used, of course, the obvious choice in the current market. I needed power, so I went for power. There was a lot of options, but there was one that stood out, which is ridiculously low price. 11th Gen i9 processor, 32 GB of RAM, best of all, and RTX 3080. Gaming, programming, video editing, 3D rendering, for this configuration, no sweat. Or just sweat, I thought. On the 80s, it says something like overheating issues. Sure, just open the windows, problem solved. This guy probably just covered up his fan intake or used ketchup instead of thermal paste. Or, you know, worst case, nothing a work of cooling can solve. So I called the guy up. I'll take it.
Who is this?
I'm on my way.
On your way to... hold on.
His boys, you got the stuff. So as he stood there explaining more and more about the PC, I was there thinking, bam, this is the deal of the century. RTX 30... Wait, and where's the rest of the PC?
He's boring!
Just that which I had not noticed in the ad is that this was one of those compact PCs. Small form factor designer shit. Designed to fit nicely into your minimalistic, aesthetically pleasing desk. Me, I went into that shit. A PC is a workhorse, a power machine. As long as it works and does the job, I'm happy. So I paid the guy the ridiculously low amount that he asked for, and I was on my way. And I would like to you, the look on this guy's face was always, this guy is going to beat me up when he finds out how shit this PC is. I should not have sold it. So I arrived home, happy, plug in this box looking thing, hook everything up and... are jets checking off from my balcony again? What's going on?
Is there barbecue making hurricanes for breakfast?
Блядь! So apparently that shit noises and everything. Open up Premiere, start the render, 5 minutes in, problem confirmed. Now it is not the blue screen of death, but I know for a fact that this means that some components are not playing along well. Problem replicated, time to synthesize solution. So I went to BIOS, check out what's going on. First thing I see, 4 fans, only one working, what the fuck? But this probably just means it has capability for 3 more fans. This is good news for me. What was not good news, however, was the fact that the fan configuration was already in silent. Silent in what world? Now you could take manual control and push everything to zero, but you know, that is how files get started. So I switched to normal configuration, assuming the manufacturer know what to do. So what this screen basically says is that at 50 degrees, the fans will be working at 70%. And it's already 40 degrees. On idle.
Who made this shit?
Who the fuck at Gigabyte approved of this trash? But hey, I do like a challenge, and this PC was that cheap. Okay, so here is a small reference table for you. The fan goes up to 2100 RPM, and I measured it at something like 52 dB. But who cares about decibels? We like real life references. So about 1000 RPM, the fan is about room level. Can't really hear it unless you put your head to PC. And I am about 80 centimeters from the box. 1200 RPM, you can hear the machine is working, it's a quiet hum. It's fine. But if I was noise pollution specialist, I would say yes, the machine probably needs cleaning. 1400 RPM, you can clearly hear there is something going on. Makes you wonder what the noise is. If you're wearing headphones, you can still hear it. And for extended period of time, it make you go crazy. At 1600 RPM is what I like to call, is it going to be all the time, nah? A short time of this, fine. Or after a long gaming session, I understand the machine heats up. But if you're listening to music with your headphones, you can hear this, and it is really fucking annoying. Now we get to 1800 RPM. Now this is the type of noise that I can only suggest is coming from a very old, very dusty PC that you're trying to flash the BIOS of 20 years later. All the fans go to max speed and you cross your fingers hoping nothing bursts down. But is that all? No. Now we get to 2000 RPM. And let me tell you from what I can see, this is a 14 or 16 centimeter fan. These are meant to go up to 1200 RPM. And there is a reason for that, they are fucking noisy. From which fantasy land, devil's asshole, they managed to pull out 37 dB, playing any game besides Notepad is a mystery for me. No, actually, I take that back. You would have to unplug and throw away the power cable for it to make 37 dB. So basically what I'm saying, at 2000 RPM, it sounds like it is going to crash at any second. It is noisy, you can hear it from 2 apartments away.
package that noise, all Boris must be home again.
You can listen to music loud on your headphones, and you can be sure that the PC will be an instrument playing.
And yes, the fans go even higher at 2100 RPM. I would much rather pull out my hair and eat my socks. But to hear you sing Bad Boris, these are the maximum speeds. You never reach maximum speeds. PC's big fans are very quiet, actually. Wrong! So what we have established, above 1400, everything is annoying, noisy. And from what I can tell, there is just one big fan doing all the work. Let me give you some real-life examples of this PC. Powering up, 2000 RPM. Okay, forgivable, fine. It's probably some kind of self-test. Booting to Windows and doing absolutely nothing. Want to guess? 2000 RPM. Okay, fine, there's probably a lot of updates and stuff going on, things are starting up. So okay, 5 minutes in, doing absolutely nothing for 5 minutes, 1800 RPM. What would you, how did I describe it exactly? A 20-year-old PC filled with dust. Sure, this sounds like it. So, okay, I mean, it's a fresh Windows install. Everything's already updated, but you know, the pool light is updated every week, every day. So, let's wait 10 more minutes. No, let's make it 15 more minutes of not touching the PC at all. Want to guess? 1600 RPM. I thought of making some more tests, but there is really no point. The PC, like this, completely unusable. The temperatures, however, actually not so bad. 45-50 degrees is okay. 70-75 degrees while gaming is fine. But 1500-1600 RPM doing nothing, and 2100 a full lot. I would much rather game inside a jet engine. Let's crack this sucker open, see what's inside. I mean, come on, what you expect? The i9 alone, and the fucking K model. Не за cooling system, it is as big as this box alone. And i5, i7 at best. But 11900K might as well break out the pen and fry some eggs in this sucker. It is a nice looking thing though, but this tech hidden inside, it deserves a better enclosure than this coffin. At least I not went crazy with the RGB, I respect that. TMF5 ton. You get more than one of these in a room, you might as well make reservations at fire department, блять. Just as I thought. Manufactured middle of last year, this means this guy probably bought it like 2 months later. Давай, ну point praying на! Dr. Boris going in! Hold on, the only fan in the case is connected to GPU? What type of backyard Gopnik logic is this? What did this shit hit up? You could have attached a whole 2 more fans to this shit! But you still not be running when the CPU gets hot. Oh, look at me, a complete Christoph Columbus here for another fan. Let's hope this runs. I'm guessing it doesn't. Powering up. Whoa! And we have liftoff! Shit, he's trying to fly back to homeland! I already forgot how loud this shit is! What are you doing? Okay, I know I see a problem. So the bottom fan does all the work, and this is the CPU header fan. And the GPU only kicks in when the GPU needs it. Which means it's just blocking the air otherwise. Okay, solution number one, let's replace the bottom main fan with a much quieter one. I mean, I have to give credit, this is some next level custom made stuff. I mean, yes, parts of the GPU will overheat more than a fresh batch of borscht, but uniting the heat sinks on top of the CPU is an elegant solution. I would do the same if I had an i5, of course. And here we have completely empty 3 lonely fan headers for the case. Completely wasted opportunity. Happy birthday, camera. Hey! Hey, come back. Happy birthday, Mr. Hey, Artyom! Come on, I brought you fresh fish. Are you taking me to your family? I just wanted the sunlight. Artyom is a self-made man. He's 4 years old. He is big boy, can handle himself. And unfortunately... Hey, where are you going? Well, unfortunately for me, fortunately for Comrade Cat. I have decided to let him
Live here. Out in the wilds with бабушка. My apartment way too small. And Kitty.
He's happy here.
Yeah, you did good job. Protect from Vadim. Now you protect бабушка from angry bird. Or angry neighbor. Or mailman. Whichever come first. I come visit. Every week. I promise. Давай, take care of бабушка. I have to go.
Well, I'm not sure what I expected, but not this.
It's time for Plan B.
Now that will fit the 99. And since there are no aftermarket heatsinks for this unbranded unknown Gigabyte 3080, I will be using the one that came with it. And the ceiling fan plus 32 board. And if nothing more, it does make a nice art piece. Especially compared to the comically small motherboard. Let's build this sucker. And water cooling, the obvious choice, especially for i9K processor. Basically done, had to flip this fan around to blow some air into the case along with these two, and that is because this fan is blowing in that direction. Heating holder here, very professional. Water pump here, pipes go straight to radiator, which again blow air out of the case. Not too complicated, three fans in, three fans out. After synchronizing them to my needs, I will probably not even have to touch them. Let's go, fire one. I name you the Roadside Picnic. First boot. Water moving, good. Pump is active. Ага, fan switched off. Everything quiet. This hopefully means the hardware is trying to play well with each other. It's like learning to breathe for the first time. Here we go. О!
Victory for Boris!
Ха-ха! First try, блин! So, the CPU fan, I had radiator fans for the water cooling. And system fan 1 is the water pump. System fan 2 are the three fans blowing air in. When we have 35 CPU temperature. Ха! Well, it's better than 48, I'll tell you that. I mean, there will have to be some bit of fine... There will have to be some bit of fine tuning. Especially with the fan speech deciding on which level of Вадим, блять! Well, would you look at it? 31 degrees on the CPU and 32 on the GPU. Come on! And all for the price of a normal sized case. With some water cooling, of course. So moral of story is just don't buy a pre-built.
The noise in this machine. Look, I have to go closer. You have to go exactly to the fan. This is how PC should sound on idle. I'm whispering. You can already hear it.
And that, little boys and girls, is how Commander Boris, Master Chef, Slav Superstar, got a deal of a century. No, a lifetime.
just because the previous owner got swindled out of his money by the manufacturer. Just don't buy pre-built, come on. Have a good night. Stitching Brick, I'll see you next time.